Welcome to How It Works, the video series from LawSites and LawNext, in which you get to see hands-on demonstrations of legal tech products directly from their developers. In today's episode, we're looking at MyCase Legal Accounting, easy-to-use accounting software built seamlessly into the MyCase practice management platform to meet the unique business needs of law firms. Joining me to tell us all about it and show us how it works is Lindsay Bushong, Sales Engineering Manager. Lindsay, welcome to How It Works.
Awesome. Hi, Bob. Thank you for having me.
Before we get into the demonstration, why don't you tell us a little bit more about MyCase and about MyCase Accounting?
Yeah, absolutely. So MyCase Accounting allows firms to confidently manage their books directly within their case management and billing software. So this means you don't have to like sync information across multiple systems, which is typically really messy and results in inaccurate finances, which nobody likes. And you get to spend way less time at the end of the month kind of looking through spreadsheets and client ledgers and all that stuff. So it really gives you a single pane of glass to make sure that you're compliant with your IOLTA accounts, to make sure your staff, they're getting properly paid, and really just give you some more peace of mind so you can, you know, finally take that beach vacation that you've been dying to have.
Perfect. All right. Well, why don't you go ahead and share your screen and show us how it works?
I would love to. Awesome. So welcome to MyCase Accounting. The first thing we're going to take a look at here are the chart of accounts. So if I select the chart of accounts, it's going to show me all of the accounts that I have set up here. We have some suggested accounts that you can get started with right out of the box, or you're welcome to upload your own accounts. We'll help you import your opening balances here as well. You can see the name of the account, the type. You'll also be able to see the MyCase balance. And if there is a bank balance available, you'll see that here as well. Obviously, this is a demo account, so a lot of these are blank. But you would be able to see if there's any discrepancies between those almost immediately here. And if we click into any of these accounts, for example, our advanced client costs, so for all of our disbursements, if I click View Register, we'll be able to see all of the transactions that have been automatically recorded. So I mentioned earlier that you don't have to sync any information. It's going to be accurate. It's directly from your front-end billing, which is all taken care of in MyCase as well here under the Billing tab. And so we can see all of these individual transactions. And if I want to see the debits and credits that have been recorded, we can just click the View button here on the right-hand side, which would open up a new window where we can see the debits and credits associated with that account. Any questions on the chart of accounts?
Well, just I wanted to make sure I heard you correctly that you come out of the box with recommended accounts, but if a law firm wants to add other accounts, they can do that. Is that right?
Yeah, absolutely. So we have some examples here. Like you can see, I've added my payroll account and a sub account for that. I just added that by clicking the Add New Account in the upper right. We'll also help you import them when you get started.
Perfect. Thank you.
So next, we're actually going to jump over to the banking tab. So if I click on banking here, it's going to show me all of my bank accounts, not just my trust account, but also any operating accounts, any credit card accounts. Again, we'll be able to see the MyCase balance and the bank balance. And what's going to happen is MyCase will pull our bank statement directly into the system so that we can post or clear our transactions as they come through. So you can see these are, again, your bank statement. Like if you go and look at your online banking, that's what you would see here. MyCase is going to find matches within the system, and it will allow you to add them directly here. We would just click match. If you're using LawPay for your financial transactions, so any online payment, we'll actually automatically create deposit slips and match that for you. So essentially, you wouldn't need to match or post any online transaction. Any thoughts or questions there?
Well, I noticed the reference to MyCase Smart Spend, and is that what you're talking about there?
So Smart Spend is actually a little bit different and a great segue. I did want to mention that. So with Smart Spend, you'll be able to have a credit card that would automatically log the expenses here into MyCase, which is really cool. I know a lot of times, you know, people are using personal credit cards or, you know, you forget the receipt or you forget to upload something. So it'll actually automatically create the expense record so you can get it on your invoice so that you can get it into your accounts. And it'll all be here referenced directly in the system.
Got it. Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. And so under the banking tab, there's a couple other functions we can take a look at. We have those deposit slips that I mentioned. So LawPay deposit slips will be created automatically. But if, you know, we have 10 checks that we're taking to the bank, we can, of course, create a deposit slip here and match that much, much more easily than each of the individual invoices and their transactions. We can also create and write checks here. So we have some examples of some checks. You can void them, you can manage them, reprint, and these can be associated with sort of operational expenses or your advanced client costs. You can actually write checks directly from an expense. Next, we're going to look at the bills and expenses tab. So this is where we can see all of our advanced client costs under the client expenses tab, which I definitely want to talk about, but also all of our bills, which are going to be all of your operational expenses or firm overhead. So really nice to be able to manage your payables in the same system that you're doing all of your AR. So we can see we have our saved vendors. You can add a bill in the upper right-hand corner here. You can choose the account that this is associated with. You can even split it between multiple accounts, which is really handy here. And you'll be able to write checks for all these expenses if you need to. For our client expenses, it's worth noting this payment status. A lot of the firms that I work with find this really helpful because they'll have folks who add the expense into the system, but then like a bookkeeper or an admin, they come in and actually write the check or mark the expenses paid by the firm. So you can track the status of that here on the right. And just generally better visibility into all of your expenses and expense management here. Any questions on bills and expenses?
I guess maybe a higher level question related to this is whether there are administrative controls within MyCase as to who can access the accounting or who can do things like write checks and that sort of thing.
Yeah, that's a great question. So the way that MyCase Accounting works is that only the users who have been granted access to the accounting tab would see these items. So you do need to have an accounting license. Typically, that's like maybe a partner or an office admin. If you have like a billing specialist, so one or two people at the firm. You can also set up specific settings so that everybody can write checks or only specific users who have accounting can write checks. So there are varying levels of permissions here. I think something else that's really helpful is that you do get a free CPA license. So if you want to actually share that login with your CPA so they can come in for tax season and grab the reports and look at the bills and everything like that, you can actually give them a login here instead of like sending a bunch of emails and reports back and forth, that kind of thing.
Right, which most firms would want to do.
Yeah, absolutely. So next, we're going to take a look at the bank reconciliation tab. When I click into this tab, we'll be able to see any previously reconciled accounts, and we'll also be able to reconcile a new account. So at the end of the month, when you're ready to start looking through your books and matching your bank transactions with your MyCase transactions, that's actually all going to be preset for you. If you remember from the banking tab, we're posting and we're pre-clearing our transactions live as they come in directly through the bank. So at the end of the month, that should sort of already be done for you. And all you'll have to do is sort of triple check that and make sure everything looks good. So for example, with our trust account here, if I click resume, it will open and we can see that all of these transactions have already been posted for us. So they've been cleared with the bank and with the MyCase transactions. What's really great about our three-way trust reconciliation is we're reconciling, again, that bank account, our trust liability, and our trust asset account. So we have all of that information already in the system, so we can pull it together to create that three-way trust reconciliation. If everything was perfect in an ideal world, we don't have to fix anything, it will turn green, your books will balance, and you'll be able to click save. What that's going to do is it's going to produce your trust reconciliation report. Here's a sample of that, where again, we're going to have our MyCase transactions, our bank transactions, and all of our individual client trust ledgers.
Very, very critical for bar compliance in a lot of states.
Yeah, absolutely. And so you'll have all of these reports on file. You can pull them up at any time, print them out, send them, share them with whoever you need. Any other questions here on reconciliation?
Well, it hasn't turned green in this example, right?
That's correct.
So that's because there's the unclear transactions aren't matching with the clear transactions. Is that why that is?
Yeah, absolutely. So you'll see if we scroll down here, there's like a bunch of like outdated items and things that aren't selected mm-hmm. yet. So typically what would happen is you would see the transaction here at the bottom, and it's going to allow you to either exclude it, and we can include it in the following month, or we can go back and fix it. Because it's a single system, if there's an error, we have to go back to the original invoice or the original payment so that we can make sure everything's compliant sort of end to end. So it would actually lead you back to the original invoice or the expense, and you could fix it there within the billing portion, and it will update back into accounting.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I mean, that's a common problem where there's something that hasn't yet cleared through, and therefore they don't quite sync up at that point.
Yeah, absolutely. So you could like a payment that comes in late or something, you could exclude it for the next month or save it for later.
Right.
And so all of this work that you're doing to reconcile your accounts and manage your books will allow you to create your financial statements. So within the report section, when you have access to accounting, you'll then get access to these financial statements, such as your income statement. We can run this report. You can see it's pretty standard, but it does have these toggles so that we can hide or expand specific sections. And you can also choose the period that you want to run this for. So again, with that free CPA license, they'll have access to this as well. But you can always export these to a PDF or Excel file. And then we have like our balance sheet and cash flow, a full general ledger report. So if you really want to dive into the specific transactions on the account, we could produce that report as well. So I'll jump back into accounting here. The last section I want to show off is the dashboard. And this is just the first screen that you would see when you open the accounting module. And when you get started, there's a couple of steps that we walk you through. So this makes kind of switching accounting systems that much easier because we're going to move you through the different things that need to be completed to get started. And so that's going to include, you know, setting up your chart of accounts, syncing your data from MyCase, syncing your bank accounts. And we, of course, have training and support and onboarding for all of this. We actually require you to do some onboarding before you get started so that you start on the right foot here. And so you'll see this section when you first sign in. And then once you start using MyCase Accounting, you'll have these really nice reports that you can filter by attorney, you can filter by practice area. Again, why having accounting built into your case management is really cool, because we can filter for sort of those kinds of categories that we already have set up in the system. Any other questions on MyCase Accounting?
No, it looks great. I'm really glad you were able to give us this this overview of it today.
Awesome. Yeah, absolutely. Thank you for having me.
Well, thanks for being here. And that's it for this episode of How It Works. You can find the full series at directory.lawnext.com under the Resources tab, or we have all these videos posted up on YouTube. You can find them there as well. This is Bob Ambrogi. Thanks for being with us today.